Let's update the firmware in a Godox TT685 today in the studio. Hello there, my name is Alex Silva. If you're new to this channel, consider subscribing in order to learn more about photography in general and flash photography in particular. Today we're talking about updating the firmware in a Godox TT685. I'd like to explain why we want to upgrade the firmware, the whole process, the preparation, the actual update, and how to test if everything went well. Of course, you can see the chapters in the description below, so if you want to skip to a specific section, you can just go ahead. So why would you want to update the firmware in a flash? In this particular case, I want my TT685 to be able to use the ID feature, which it currently doesn't have. In some other cases, you may want to update the firmware in order for your flash to recognize probably new camera models. I think this has been an issue with Canon cameras. So maybe updating the firmware will make sure that your camera works with your 77D or T7i, things like that. Anyway, let's continue with the actual process. First, we need to check what is the current version in our flash, the current version of the firmware. So how do we check this? It's super simple. You only turn the flash on and then long press the zoom or function button until you get to the menu. Then you will see the version of your firmware in this corner, in the upper right corner. In my case, it's version 1.0. I'm kinda behind the times. Then we need to download the installer. In my case, I'm going to use the Flashpoint installer. Is there any particular reason for it? Well, my flashes are actually Flashpoint. As far as I know, Flashpoint flashes are Godox flashes, just rebranded by Adorama. I bought my flashes from Adorama. I'm going to use their software. But as far as I know, it is the exact same software. The updates are exactly the same and the process should be the same. But anyway, so we get the firmware updates, both the installer and the actual firmware for the specific flash from Adorama's website. I'm going to make sure that I link this site in the description below. Sorry, you can identify your product. In my case, this is called a Zoom Flash. It is the same as the Godox TT685. And it tells me that the Fuji version of this flash needs to use the F1 software. I already downloaded it. And it's in my software folder. I'm going to, I need to extract this. It takes a minute. Kind of hung there for a minute, and then we have the installer. In order to install this, I need to check something really quick. It has more or less the same instructions as the Godox. So I'm just going to make sure that I install this. I'm not just going to right click on this file, which is the installer. I'm going to right click on it and run as administrator. I need to grant permission, administrative permission to this software. it runs and installs just like any other piece of software. Agree to the terms. Yeah. Next, next, next. It installs and actually installs the G1 software. It's the same thing as Godox. So we finish. And yeah, we need to install some drivers. Okay. Would you like to install this device software? Yes, install. Sure, we're going to install this. So, no problems here so far. I'm going to open and look for the recently installed software, and I'm going to make sure that I run it as administrator. I'm not just going to click on this, I'm going to make sure that I run it as administrator. The G1.exe, it's G1, the Godox updater. So there's one very important thing to consider here. We need to use we're going to connect the flash to the computer through a micro USB cable. Make sure that it's a reasonably good quality cable. In my case, I got this cable from Sony, back when Sony made cables. So this is what I'm going to connect. And number two that you're going to need, you need to remove the batteries from your flash. Make sure the batteries are out. And if at some point you saw my Godox TT685 setup video, you know that this flash has a micro USB port on the side. So we're going to connect the cable there. We're going to select where's this? Godox firmware updates. The actual software. No. The firmware. Let me check again. Yeah, this is for the TT350. This is for the X Pro, the transmitter. So this is for the Zoom TTL. There we go. So we're going to switch again to the installer, the updater. Dang it! Ah, yeah, we were opening the file. Loading completed. Matching product. Sure. Let's connect. Connect completed. I needed to turn the flash off. I forgot that I had it on. Then I'm going to select the file. And upgrade. It erased the flash. Nice. Nice. Okay, very good. So we're going to exit. Things seem to have gone smoothly. Let's see. Yeah, let's see if everything works correctly. I'm placing the batteries again on my flash. And let's see if everything's working correctly. It turns on, no problems there. And if I long press the function button. Yes, we have a version 1.1. And there you have it. We updated the firmware on a Godox TT685. We went from why we may want to do this, to update the firmware. We prepared ourselves, we did the actual update, and we finally tested it. I really hope you found this video interesting, informative, but also entertaining. If that is the case, please press the like button. You can also subscribe to the channel or share this video with your friends. But most of all, please remember to stay safe, keep learning, and keep creating. And I'll see you in the next video.